Sharing a couple things and kind of talking these ladies up here a little bit. Matt said that it was Jim, Lori, and Nikki, or Nicole, but obviously I'm Jim, but so to my right, immediately here in the middle, is Lori. Just want to talk them up a little bit. She's a wonderful person and has a great love of the Lord. We all met on the worship team at church, and we started singing together for an Easter event years ago. Yep. Just loved how it sounded, and we kind of kept doing it ever since. Love how we sing together and sound together. But Lori is a professional salesperson. She's in the dental world. And I think it's very fitting for her because she's so friendly, so personable, and so just right out there and just loves on everybody. So would you please welcome Lori? And at the end is Nicole. Again, Nicole is another wonderful woman, very godly woman, and very glad to be working with her. She is an elementary music school teacher. She also has a photography business on the side, and she has sung with the Toledo Philharmonic. We're very honored to have her with us as well. Would you please welcome Nikki? Now, I told the girls earlier I was going to share a couple things about them. They said, well, what about you? Well, I don't want to talk about me, but I will say my claim to fame is that I am married to Wendy Collins. I didn't embarrass her, but it's only meant to embarrass her. I didn't want to embarrass her. I've had kind of a passion, and I talked a little bit about this when we were at the chapel at Brotherhood, and what a great thing it is that you have a chapel, and you have that that privilege to do that, take a half hour out of work and do that. So we were honored to be there for that, and I did share a couple of things about some of our passions, and my passion in particular. I kind of grew up in a Baptist church, which means I like hymns, and I don't like change. So, I'm getting older, I'm getting there. So, but I always heard the hymns with an organ, and I was like, it's okay. And as I got older, I learned to realize that the hymns have this amazing reverence. I love that about them. And I've been hearing a lot of other artists taking hymns and kind of doing their own thing with them, and I really like that, especially when I get to hear them do them with an acoustic guitar instead of an organ. So with that, we just did Turn Your Eyes Upon Jesus. That kind of laid upon our hearts here some weeks ago. And this next one is Leaning on the Everlasting Arms. One of my favorite artists, Ron Block, who is from Alison Krauss, I saw him do this, and I really liked how he did it. We kind of did our own thing. So here's how that goes. What a fellowship, what a joy divine, leaning on the everlasting arms. What a blessedness, what a peace is mine, leaning on the everlasting arms. Thank you.
Calvary's hill and wore the crown of thorns he wore. I know why he bled and died upon that rugged cross and bore the pain that he bore for me. Ever drawn breath of life, he can see me in his mind. And he knew he had to die just for me. I've not been an angel by any means at all. When I needed forgiveness, all I had to do was call on Jesus, my Savior, and he pulled me through, gave me eternal life and hope. He'll do the same. Ever drawn the breath of life, he can see you in his mind. And he knew he had to die, if just for you, for me, for everyone that's ever drawn the breath of life, he can see. And the reason that he died was just for you.
So, since it is Christmas, why don't we do a couple Christmas songs? This particular one. Yep, you're going to remind me to take this off, aren't you? Okay, so this particular one is In the Bleak Midwinter, arranged by our very own Nicole. We're looking forward to her singing this. Okay?
Hallelujah, hallelujah to
Love her so well.
Thank you.